Hello and welcome in our lab here in Ettlingen. I'm delighted to show you today how you can use FT-IR to monitor chemical reactions. First, I will outline the basic experimental setup to study heterogeneous catalysis, gas-solid interactions, photochemical reactions and oxidation mechanisms. After that, we will use a practical example to illustrate how the setup works and how to perform the experiment with our software. At the end of the video, I will show you options how to increase the performance of the setup and also how to tailor it exactly to your requirements. During this demonstration, we would like to perform reaction monitoring using light diffusely scattered from the sample, the so-called DRIFTS configuration. This technique is particularly suitable for samples with rough surfaces and powders and is used in the development of catalysts, monitoring of reaction kinetics, and to study temperature effects or the analysis of soil samples, among other things. Getting started is super convenient. The large sample compartment and quick lock mechanism make it very easy to set up INVENIO for this configuration. It guarantees an error-free mechanical installation, provides auto-recognition of the installed measurement accessory, and delivers purge gas to the measuring accessory. The accessory we use for our drifts measurement is the Praying Mantis from Herrick. It focuses the incident beam coming from the spectrometer onto the sample, collects the diffusely reflected light containing the chemical information, and guides it back to the INVENIO. Let me get the accessory and put it into the spectrometer. This big window on the top can be used for observation. If we want to study solid gas reactions, we need to add the reaction gases to the sample, and the Praying Mantis reaction chamber perfectly serves that purpose. These connections are used to supply gas to the sample or evacuate the cell. In addition, the reaction chamber also offers the possibility to carry out the investigations at high temperatures via a heating element. The electric current and the cooling water for controlling the temperature in the chamber are supplied through these connectors. And here is our sample. Calcium oxalate hydrate, a powdered salt with bound crystalline water. Inserting this or other samples in powder form is simple. Open the sample dome, place the filling guide around the sample cup, insert the metal grid into the sample cup, and fill it with the sample. Brush off excess material with the spatula. The sample surface must be even across the entire surface area. Remove the filling guide and mount the sample dome. We insert the reaction chamber into the Praying Mantis. To mount the chamber, only this screw must be tightened. Through these two windows, the IR radiation can be directed to and from the sample. The third window is used for shining additional radiation from an external source into the reaction chamber. For example, when photochemical processes are to be studied. Optical alignment is accomplished by adjusting this screw. At this point, you also need to connect your desired gas lines and the controller for the heating element, which completes the basic experimental setup. In a drift experiment, optical throughput is severely limited and thus poses the highest demands on an FT-IR instrument. The sensitivity and the signal-to-noise ratio are particularly important, and this is exactly where INVENIO can show off. The beam path of INVENIO has been optimized to maximize throughput and sensitivity. At the same time, its detectors show a very low noise level thanks to the built-in electronics. All this enables us to extract as much information as possible from drifts measurements and other low-light applications. Now let's move on to the demonstration. We expect the calcium oxalate hydrate to lose its crystalline bound water when heated up to temperatures of above 100 degrees C. As a result, the corresponding absorption bands of the OH groups at around 3300 wave numbers in the IR spectrum should decrease during the heating process. A look at the IR spectra before and after the heating process clearly shows the decrease of the absorbent signal in the expected range. So, our sample is losing its bound water. With our reaction monitoring software package, we can not only compare the spectra before and after the reaction, but also follow the change of these or other relevant bands in situ and always know live how far the reaction has progressed. So let's take a closer look and watch the sample lose its water. What you see in this 3D plot is exactly the absorption band's region of crystalline water. The third axis is the time axis. As you can see, new data is constantly added to the 3D plot. The curve on the right shows the change of the total band intensity over time, or, in our case, during the warming. For this, we've integrated the absorption signal of the OH bands over the wave number range shown on the left. The result of the integration is plotted against time, giving us a curve that tells us how far the outgassing process has progressed. The integration methods are configurable and can thus be adapted to various investigations. We started with data acquisition at 80 degrees C and applied a heating rate of 10 degrees C per minute. At the beginning, we can already notice a slow and continuous decrease of the OH bands, which can be attributed to powder reconstruction and removal of ambient moisture during heating. The actual dehydration reaction starts after 2 minutes, where the band intensity starts to decrease much faster until it is almost reaching zero. This indicates complete dehydration after another period of about 4 minutes. You can rotate the 3D plot during the measurement to observe the spectra over time more closely, until you are sure the reaction is over. Then, you can manually stop the measurement. The data will be automatically saved, including all spectra and trace information. Did you notice that we never talked about measurement parameters? That's because it really matters to which user group you belong. So far, we presented the INVENIO as a turnkey solution for out-of-the-box DRIFTS measurements. However, this approach only fits to one of the user groups. The other user group requires a little bit more. So, if your research requires it, you can tune the experimental parameters of INVENIO in such a way that all the reaction dynamics are fully captured. Let me give you some examples. In heterogeneous catalysis measurements, a short-lived intermediate is the key to understanding the catalysis process, for example, a surface-anchored and activated reaction molecule. In many cases, these intermediates have a lifetime of only a few hundreds of milliseconds, which may only be detected if we can measure fast enough. Take another example. You are investigating a photo-induced reaction that starts exactly when you illuminate your sample. Manually controlling the illumination and the IR spectrometer simultaneously is not only inconvenient, it may lead to inaccuracies. Obviously, the perfect synchronization of the IR spectrometer, other laboratory devices, and the exact definition of the measurement points is desirable. A third example, a chemical reaction in which the dynamics change dramatically. It might have a fast start, but slows down after some time until the reaction is finished. Adjusting the temporal resolution to the dynamics of the reaction during measurement would be very valuable here. The rapid scan package for our IR systems is the optimal solution. It allows you to flexibly adapt your measurement to any reaction. Let's look at the features. An INVENIO with rapid scan TRS measurement function can achieve a temporal resolution of up to tens of milliseconds, which enables to measure more than 70 spectra per second using 16 wave number spectral resolution. The rapid scan function includes a method editor to make the user experience more convenient. For example, it includes flexible and advanced trigger options. The set trigger high and set trigger low commands are used if the spectrometer should be the master and send a trigger to start or stop the measurement or any other event. The weight input low or high commands are used if the external experiment or event should control the spectrometer. You can also run subsequent measurements with different time resolutions. For example, we can set a first loop taking 100 measurements while having 10 scans per measurement, and then start a second loop taking only 5 measurements but with 1000 scans per measurement. This program measurement series delivers high temporal resolution for the beginning of the reaction and cuts down the data volume in the slow phase of the reaction without changing the scan velocity. All spectra will be then presented in one 3D plot. More details about Rapid Scan Method Editor can be found in another video listed below. Let me sum up here. DRIFTS can be used in applications such as chemical reaction monitoring in heterogeneous catalysis or photo-induced reactions. High sensitivity and signal-to-noise ratio are especially important for DRIFTS because the IR signals are very small. INVENIO offers the performance for DRIFTS applications and can be adapted perfectly to your reaction by utilizing rapid scan, dedicated detectors or trigger functionalities. And in case you encounter new challenges in your research, your INVENIO can be upgraded or retrofitted with any function at any time. Now thanks for watching and see you soon!